Okay, so see, in previous lecture we have derived expression for E1 and E2, that is 4.44 FIM N1 and 4.44 FIM N2. So if you take the ratio of E2 by E1, you will get N2 by N1, and that is called as capital K transformation ratio. Okay, and from KVA rating we have seen KVA rating is equal into 10 to the power 3 is equals to V1 I1 is equals to V2 I2. Means you will get V2 by V1 is equals to I1 by I2. This is from KVA rating we are getting the formula. Now, voltage equation on primary and voltage equation on secondary we have seen. What is it on primary? It's V1. V1 is equal to E1 plus I1 R1. Means whatever the input voltage you apply on primary, it has to overcome self-induced EMF in primary plus I1 R1 drop. And what is the voltage equation on secondary side? Whatever the EMF get induced in secondary, how it get utilized, some voltage drop will be there across primary winding resistance, and the rest is applied to load. Means E2 is equals to V2 plus I2 R2. But whenever the transformer, if the transformer is at no load, then whatever E2 by E1 is equals to N2 by N1, this one I can equate to V2 by V1 is equals to I1 by I2. In which condition? When the transformer is at no load. Isn't it? Means what we can say, when the transformer is at no load, we have seen this E2 is equals to V2 and E1 is equals to V1. Okay, when the transformer is at no load. That's why means when the transformer is loaded, these two separately you have to use. K is equals to E2 by E1 is equals to N2 by N1. And these two separately you have to use when the transformer is under loading condition. But when the transformer is not loaded, means secondary is open, you can equate E2 by E1 is equals to V2 by V1. Okay. And in the numericals, whenever there is a need to use this formula, transformer will be on no load only. Got it? Means you can use, as you are in first year, only this is equals to this you can use. Got the thing? Okay. So, based on this, we are going to see the numerical. So see, it is, it's a 10 KVA, KVA rating is given. Whenever it is said that it's a 10 KVA transformer, means this KVA rating under which condition of load? Under no load, half load, full load, which one condition?
Full load.
Full load, very good. Okay, full load condition. These are the specifications. Whenever in the numerical it's mentioned, it's a 10 kVA transformer, 3300 volt, 240 volt, single phase, 50 hertz. Means these are called as specifications of a transformer. On transformer, on its outer metallic body, rectangular plate, you can see these specifications. Now here 10 kVA rating is given to you. It's a full load KVA rating. Primary side, this much voltage you can apply, and on secondary maximum you will get this one, and it will be at no load condition. We have okay, at no load condition, this is the maximum voltage get induced on secondary side. Okay, or you will get across secondary this one maximum voltage. It's a single phase 50 hertz transformer. It has core area. Core cross sectional area in centimeter square is given. All of you know that core, it has vertical limb, two side limbs, it has horizontal also limb. So whatever these limbs, its cut section, if you take like this, it will be. So its front view, that cut section, its front view, its cross sectional area, means this one, it is given, it's a 300 square centimeter. Flux density is, flux density means what? Flux per unit area. Current density, all of you know, current per unit area. Similarly, flux density, flux per unit area. So unit is Weber per meter square or Tesla. So 1.3 Tesla it is given. You have been asked to calculate the primary winding full load current, secondary winding full load current, number of turns on primary and number of turns on secondary. Okay. Easy, numerical. I1 full load, I2 full load formula, you know. What is the formula for I1 full load? K KVA rating into 10 to the power 3 divided by V1 is I1 full load and divided by V2 is I2 full load. Okay. So KVA rating given 10 into 10 to the power 3 V1 you know. So you will get it 3.03 MVA. I1 full load. And I2 full load KVA rating divided by V2 240. So current you will get 41.66 ampere. Now if you observe here, this one is step up or step down transformer.
Step down.
It's a step down transformer. Correct. It's a step down transformer means voltage on secondary get reduced. So you can observe as voltage, this one 240 volt, this is 3300 volt on primary. As voltage on secondary get reduced, current you compare. See which one current will be more than I1 or I2?
I2.
Got it? V1, I1 is equals to V2, I2. If voltage you are going to step down on secondary, so current will be more on secondary. Got the thing? Okay, so I1 full load, I2 full load, we got. What is the significance of these values? Means how much you can load on transformer so that current in primary should not be more than 3.03 ampere and current in secondary should not be more than 41.66 ampere. Okay, that is the importance of this. Otherwise, transformer windings will burn. And replacement cost is very high. So better way, do not overload it. Whenever you are putting the load and current becomes beyond this value, means what does it mean? Transformer get overloaded. So never load, never overload the transformer. Okay. Again, next thing is what? You have been asked to find out the number of turns on primary and secondary. So see, here nothing is given about whether the transformer is loaded or not. So consider under no load condition. If under no load condition, then you can use this relationship. Which one? K is equals to E2 by E1 is equals to V2 by V1 is equals to N2 by N1 is equals to I1 by I2. This one formula you can use. Means which one? Specifically E2 by E1, you can equate it to V2 by V1. Okay, so E1 formula you know, 4.44 F5 M N1. Here nothing is given means transformer you can consider under no load condition. Under no load condition you can equate E1 is equals to V1 and what is V1? 3300. So put the values here. Now flux density is what is given to you? Flux density is given. See 1.3 Tesla. And cross-sectional area is given. Area, whenever we say flux density is equals to pi by A, flux is in Weber, and flux density is in Tesla or Weber per meter square. So area must be in meter square, isn't it? So area given to you 300 centimeter square. So means to convert it into meter square, what you have to do? Multiply by 10 to the power. Multiply it by 10 to the power what?
-4.
Correct. Multiply it by 10 to the power -4. Attendance link I posted in chat box. You can mark your attendance. Okay. So see here, cross-sectional area is 300 into 10 to the power -4 meter square. Cross-sectional area we got. Flux density is given. Means you can put the value of flux in that induced EMF equation. So flux is B into A. So we'll replace here flux is B into A. Okay. So even if not mentioned here, na, flux density 1.3 Tesla maximum, consider it as a maximum only. Yeah? So maximum flux density is maximum flux divided by cross-sectional area. So here, because here, if you see the, it's a maximum flux is there. So frequency is given, flux you can replace as B suffix M into A. So all values, you know, put the values, you will get value of M, 382 turns. In the options, either 381 or 382 will be there, not both. Got the thing, everyone? In the options given to you, 381 or 382, not both the options will be there. Any one will be there. So either you can write a 381 also as if you are solving the sum, or 382 turns also. But in MCQ, not both the options will be there. Any one only will be there out of this. Okay. Then for to find out N2, you can use the same formula. That is E2 is equals to 4.44 F5M N2. Like that formula also you can use, or directly transformation ratio. K is equals to N2 by N1 is equals to E2 by E1. So here transformer we are considering under no load condition. So E2 by E1 you can equate as a V2 by V1. So V2 by V1 240 divided by 3300. N1 just now we have find out 382. So you will get it 27.78 turns. So this one you can equate to 28 turns. Any difficulty with this sum? Everyone got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So see, this kind of numerical included where you have to use this formula. I1 full load, I2 full load, E1 formula for E1, same formula for E2 and transformation ratio. Based on this, this type of numericals are included, and whenever you have to use these formulas, mostly in such type of numericals, transformer given is under no load condition only. Clear? Okay. So you can equate, what I mean to say, you can equate E1 is equals to E2, E1 is equals to V1 and E2 is equals to V2. You can equate it. Okay. Again, one more we'll see on this. First we'll see, because same type it is. See, 80 kVA, 3200, 400 volt, 50 hertz single phase transformer. It has 111 turns on secondary. Calculate number of turns on primary, secondary, full load current, cross-section area of the core if the maximum flux density is 1.2 Tesla. Okay, so here, see here it is maximum flux density directly mentioned. Even if not mentioned maximum flux density, only mentioned flux density, consider it as a maximum flux density. Okay, easy, eh? So here see, that is the turns on primary you want. This E2, E1 you have, V2, it's a 3200 is V1 and 400 is V2. So you can equate it as E1 and E2. Okay? Because here a transformer you have to consider under no load condition, and N2 you know. So easily N1 you can find out by using the formula of transformation. N2 by N1 is equals to E2 by E1. So easily you will get N1, right? Then I2 full load, KVA rating you know, it's a 80 KVA transformer divided by 400. So you will get I2 full load. Then what? Cross-section area. So for that E1 or E2, any of the formula you can use. Here E2 is used. Okay, so put here value E2 you know, 4 point, you can consider E2 is equals to V2 here. Okay, 400 volt. So a frequency is given, N2 you know, easily flux you can find out. What is the unit for flux? Weber. Okay. And flux density is given to you, 1.2 Tesla. So flux density given to you, flux you find out using this EMF equation. So cross-sectional area in meter square, in centimeter square, both you can find out. You just check options given to you are in meter square or centimeter square. Accordingly, you calculate the value. Any difficulty with this sum?
No, ma'am.
Okay. We'll go for the next topic. That is the equivalent circuit of a transformer. Everyone concentrate here. equivalent circuit of transformer. No one will ask you to draw the equivalent circuit or to explain it, because it's a MCQ exam. Got it? Just you understand each and every parameter, what is its meaning, or why it is shown over here. So this is called as equivalent circuit of a transformer. So see, this is the primary winding. Again, I'm repeating that no one will ask you to draw it or to explain it. You just know the what every parameter stands for and formula. Based on that, questions you will get asked. Isn't it? So see here, you just understand the parameters and formulas here. Okay. So see here, this is the primary winding turns. This is the secondary winding turns, and two straight line indicates the core. This is the equivalent circuit of a transformer. So two straight line indicates the core. Okay. Now here on primary, we apply V1. input voltage. Current flowing through primary winding is I1. Primary winding copper resistance is R1. This parameter we know. E1 we know, it's a induced EMF in primary winding terms. Self-induced EMF formula is 4.44 F pi m N1. Okay, these parameters we have seen. Again on secondary, which one we know? That is E2, mutually induced EMF in secondary winding, formula is 4.44 F pi m N2. And we know this V1 is constant from generation up to distribution practically. And that's why flux is constant. Flux in a core remains constant. Supply frequency 50 hertz is constant. That's why E1 and E2 are also constant. These three voltages are constant. V1, E1 and E2. Okay, these are constant. Now on secondary, see, this is the EMF induced in secondary winding. R2 is the secondary winding copper resistance. This is the load. Load impedance you can mark as ZL. Okay, voltage drop across it, we used to mark it as V2 or VL. Current not shown over here, you should show current in this diagram also. And that is how much current we represent it as I2, or IL also you can represent it. You can represent it as I2 or IL. If you observe here, current flowing through load and secondary winding is same. So I2 is equals to IL. Similarly, for voltage drop across load, V2 is equals to VL. Okay. These parameters we know. The rest we'll see now. What are the rest parameters stands for? We'll see about X1 and X2. Now, what's this X1 and X2 is stands for in this equivalent circuit that we are going to see first? So, we have seen earlier the effect of leakage flux. We have seen the leakage flux. Do you remember the leakage flux? AC voltage you apply, AC current flows through primary winding. So, here AC current flows through primary winding, it produces alternating flux. That changing flux flow completes its path through core. Maximum percentage of flux completes its path through core, that is 95 to 98% flux, useful flux. But here consider air is there. So if air is there or oil is there, so what will happen? Some percentage of flux completes its path through air, and what we call it as which flux? Leakage flux. What the thing? This, you remember, similarly same thing will happen on secondary side also. First of all, we'll see about the primary side only. So this is the leakage flux. Now this leakage flux, which is completing its parts through air and not through core. This is the leakage flux. Now if you observe, this leakage flux is also changing, alternating. That leakage flux coming in contact with N1 number of turns only, primary winding. See, leakage flux I have denoted by phi L1. It is coming in contact with N1 number of turns. So what will happen as per Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction? EMF will get induced in it. So to consider the effect of this induced EMF because of leakage flux, what is done on primary, whenever equivalent circuit of transformer you wanted to represent along with the resistance, this is the resistance of copper winding. On primary side, along with resistance, leakage reactance is shown in series with R1. Okay, so in some books you will find X suffix 1 is used. You can use XL1 also. You can use X1 or XL1. Okay, so it is because of, to consider the effect of leakage flux. Got it? Similarly, same thing on secondary side. You connect some load across here, then current will flow through secondary winding. As I2 is flowing, so here also it will produce its some flux phi2, and maximum flux flows through core, but some flux will complete its path through air like this. So this is the leakage flux, which is not completing its path through core and through outside medium of the core. So this is the leakage flux. So this leakage flux is alternating. So this one I have marked as phi L2. Now it is coming in contact with turns on secondary. So as per Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, EMF will get induced on secondary. So EL2. So to consider the effect of this induced EMF, what is done on secondary side also, leakage reactance is marked as X2, or you can represent it as XL2. Okay. So what is XL1 and XL2, or X1 and X2, clear everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So to consider the effect of leakage flux, you can see in equivalent circuit of transformer, X1 and X2 parameters are there. Got it? Now here you can see I2 dash is there and I0 is there. So what is I2 dash and what is I0? We'll tell you. So see here, whenever, if you remember the topic, why flux in the core remains constant, this one we have seen, isn't it? If you remember it, I told you, I explained to you why flux in the core remains constant. Up to this point, no current is flowing through secondary. Whatever the flux flowing through core is only because of I1, isn't it? The moment you connect load and current starts to flow through secondary, it also will produce its own flux. And as per Lenz's law, its direction of this phi2 will be opposite to this one. So the moment it starts to flow these two, what transformer does? It takes additional current on primary. And how much will be its magnitude? So that the flux produced by it will be in of same magnitude and in opposite direction of the flux produced by I2. And that's why flux in the core remains constant. Okay. So it is nothing but this one current, whatever transformer additionally takes, this one in equivalent circuit is marked as I2 dash. Okay. In that circuit. Got the thing? And whatever this one current, when this one will flow I2 dash, the moment I2 starts to flow, I2 is flowing means you have connected load and secondary is closed one. Before it, this one current only was flowing, means transformer was under no load condition. And under no load condition, you rather than I1, you can denote it as I0. Okay, what does it mean? Whenever transformer is under no load condition, only this I0 flows. And as you go on putting the load on transformer, which one current flows through primary along with this, along with no load current, I2 dash. So what is I2 dash in that, and what is I0? Is this clear to everyone? We'll show you here. One minute, I'm scrolling down. See here. So I means when transformer secondary is open, only I0 will flow, no load current. Got it? But when you put some load on it, what will happen? Transformer takes additional current I2 dash. Okay, so it produces, we have seen that constant Y flux in the core remains constant. So why I0 and I2 dash clear, everyone? Okay, now see, this one I told you, this one is no load current. Now, if you imagine transformer is under no load condition, no load condition means secondary is open, isn't it? Means this load is not connected. Secondary is open. If secondary is open, will any current flow through secondary winding?
No, ma'am.
No current will flow. No, ma'am. Means will there be secondary winding copper loss?
No, ma'am.
Secondary winding copper loss will be zero, isn't it? Means which one copper loss is there? Only primary winding copper loss. And to represent it, this is the component. Primary winding copper resistance R1, and as it is under no load condition, for no load condition suffix 0 is used. Got the thing? Okay, so this is the copper winding resistance under no load condition, and means under no load transformer, how much current it has to supply? First one current, one of the parameter of the current is to overcome the primary winding copper loss at no load condition, and which is very less. And this is that current, IC. Huh? Okay. So, another thing is, if you remember, see, active component it is called. Active component, IC. And IM is called as a magnetizing component. Now consider the same thing, that transformer is under no load condition, secondary is open. So if the secondary is open, can you tell me, I told you that the current I1, no load current flowing through primary winding is very less, copper loss is very less. This one in previous lecture also we have seen. Now, can you tell me under no load condition will flux flow through core? Under no load condition, transformer, it's a constant flux machine. Load on transformer, you go on changing from no load up to full load. Flux in the core always remains constant. Number of times I told you this thing in previous lecture. So my question is, if I keep secondary open, it is under no load condition, means will flux flow in the core? Just now I told you the flux in the core remains constant from no load condition up to full load condition. Means, does it mean at no load condition flux flows through core? Yes, it flows.
Yes, ma'am.
Huh? Yes, it flows. Yeah. And what we have seen in flux is flowing through core, which losses takes place in core? What we call them? Iron loss, core loss, hysteresis loss, eddy current loss. And these losses, core losses, that is iron losses, constant or variable?
Constant.
Constant losses. Okay. So, means under no load condition, iron loss takes place. Iron loss is throughout constant. Whatever the load you put on transformer, you fully load it, half load, no load, 75% of full load, any load you put on transformer, whatever the core losses always remains constant. So, magnetization of the core under no load condition also requires, because at no load condition also flux is flowing through the core, and that's why this component is related to that magnetizing component of no load current. Means under no load condition flux is flowing through core, magnetization of the core is done, and to consider that parameter, this is the second one branch is there. Okay, so see here, what you have to keep in your mind, this one. So we have finished here all the things, only this formula you keep in your mind. What is IM and what is IC? IM is called as magnetizing component, IC is called as active component. And formula is I0 sin phi and I0 cos phi. Phasor diagram not there in your syllabus. Still, how I0 sin phi and how I0 cos phi, that will explain in brief to all of you. Phasor diagram not there in your syllabus. So see, alternative flux flowing through core, that V1 here, and as per Lenz's law, we know that E1 and E2 acts in opposite direction with supply voltage. So you can see here, whatever V1 and even E2 direction are opposite to each other. Now, magnetizing component. If you observe this, it is in phase with flux, because it is related to magnetization of the core. And this is the IC. It's related to primary winding copper loss. So copper loss means resistance. And for resistance, we have seen voltage and current are in phase. That's why IC shown in phase with V1. Okay. And whatever the resultant of IC and IM is no load current, I0. And whatever the angle between V1 and I0 is Φ0. Power factor at no load condition. Power factor angle at no load condition on primary. So if you take sine and cos in this triangle, you will get these formulas. Which one formula? That is, IM is I0 sin phi and IC is I0 cos phi. Okay. So, only formula and what these are called. That is only there in your syllabus, not the phasor diagram. Okay. So, IM is magnetizing component and IC is active component. Okay. So, all the parameters here got clear.
Any yes, ma'am.
With this? Okay. Now,
Is it in VL Thareja, this topic?
Yes, yes, yes. Volume 2, please.
Okay.
You please. Okay. So, equivalent circuit of transformer we have seen now. Now, if you see, this is the, if you do separately, this is the equivalent circuit of a transformer, isn't it? Now, if you do separately calculations on primary and separately calculations on secondary, so rather than that, what is done when there is a need to do the calculations on transformer, So rather than doing separately on primary and rather than doing separately on secondary, you can make calculations more easy. How you can make more easy, whatever all these parameters on secondary, you transfer it on primary. How to transfer that we are going to see. And once you transferred all these parameters referred to primary, then it is called, okay, then that one circuit, see here. Referred to primary, equivalent circuit referred to primary. So primary side parameters remains as it is here, all of you can see. All these primary side parameters remain as it is, only whatever the parameters on secondary were there, they all transferred on primary, and that's why it is called as equivalent circuit referred to primary. And whatever the secondary side parameters, see, as they are transferred on primary, so dash 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 is marked. Okay, so how to transfer them, that we are going to see. And reverse also you can do. Keep secondary parameters as it is, and whatever all the parameters on primary, that you transmit on secondary. Okay. That you transmit on secondary. Okay. So this is called as exact equivalent circuit referred to secondary. Okay. So this one, what you can do, keep secondary parameters as it is. See here, all secondary parameters are as it is. See, all these secondary parameters are as it is, and only primary are transferred to secondary, and that's why it is called as equivalent circuit referred to secondary. And whatever the primary side parameters, see, all dash dash dash, they are marked. Okay, so how to transmit, that we are going to see. And why there is a need to transmit the parameters? To make calculations easy. That's it. Okay, so for that, what you can do? Suppose aapko primary mein transmit karna hai, all parameters. So that is called as referred to primary. So for that, what you have to do? Whatever the resistance, reactance and impedance divided by K square. And whenever you wanted to transmit from primary to secondary, multiplied by K square. So why divide by K square? Why multiplied by K square? It's logic I'm going to tell you. So what is done? See, total copper loss, you know, primary and secondary winding copper loss is there. So I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. Now I wanted to transfer all parameter to primary from secondary. Okay. So what I'll do from this equation, I'll take I1 square common. Take I1 square common. So if you take I1 square common, you will get here like this. What is I2 by I1? K transformation ratio we know. N2 by N1, E2 by E1, V2 by V1 is equals to I1 by I2. So I2 by I1 means what? 1 by K. So its square will be there. So what you will get here, see, means if you see here, this is the primary winding resistance. This is the current flowing through primary winding. Okay. So this is what we can say. This one is the resistance transferred on primary. And this is the resistance of R2 hai. R2 means what? Secondary winding. So R2 divided by K square means whenever resistance, reactance, same is the case, reactance also. Whenever resistance, reactance or impedance you wanted to transmit from secondary to primary, divided by K square. Okay. No one will ask you about current and voltage. Only you will get asked in terms of resistance, reactance and impedance. So what you have to do? Resistance R2, X2 and Z2 from secondary, whenever I am using suffix 2, instead of secondary, whenever you wanted two parameters from secondary to primary, divide it by K square. So what is R2 by K square it is called? It is the resistance of secondary winding. So equivalent resistance of secondary winding referred to primary is R2 by K square, and which is denoted as R2 dash. In numericals, this R2 is given to you, value of V2, V1 is given to you, you can calculate K, and they will ask you just calculate equivalent resistance of secondary referred to primary. Means what you have to do? R2 divided by K square, that's it. And that is denoted as R2 dash. Okay. So this R2 dash, see here, R2 dash, it's a equivalent resistance of secondary referred to primary. Why secondary? It's the equivalent resistance of secondary because suffix 2 is there. And refer to primary R2 dash, R2 by K square. So on primary side, R1 is already there. You transferred resistance from secondary to primary. Okay?
Yes,
so,
ma'am.
You transfer resistance from secondary to primary, that is R2 dash. So this is the total resistance on primary side. This is the total resistance on primary side, and that is marked as R1E. So what is R1E? Total equivalent resistance of transformer referred to primary. Whenever in numerical you get asked, calculate equivalent resistance of transformer referred to primary or total equivalent resistance of transformer referred to primary, means R1E you have to calculate, which is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. And what is R2 dash? R2 by K square. Okay. And means they will ask you either to calculate R2 dash or R1E. Only formula you have to keep in your mind. Clear to everyone these two things?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Related to this, only numerical you will get asked. This formula you keep in your mind. Okay. They will ask you calculate equivalent resistance of secondary referred to primary. Means you have to do R2 by K square. That is R2 dash you calculate. Or another one also, that is calculate total equivalent resistance of a transformer referred to secondary. Agar ye aap dono dekhte ho na, to referred to primary. Yahan pe kya hai? Yahan pe sirf equivalent resistance of secondary word hai, jo isme nahi hai. Otherwise referred to primary or equivalent resistance dono taraf hai. What the thing? Okay. So these two. Same is the case for reactants also. What it will be for reactants? See, X2 means whenever you will transmit X2 from secondary to primary. So what it will be? X2 by K square. And you have to denote it by what? X2 dash. What you can call it? Same as that of resistance. Equivalent resistance of equivalent reactance of secondary referred to primary. Okay. You may get asked calculate X2 dash. That is X2 by K square or X1E. So on primary side, X1 is already there. You transferred X2 dash also. Addition of these two is X1E. And same as that of resistance. What is X1E? Total equivalent reactance of transformer referred to primary. Any difficulty with this?
No, ma'am.
Huh? Okay. Same thing you have to do when you transmit the parameter from primary to secondary. Now see, that is called as referred to secondary. So referred to secondary means from this equations, take I2 square common. Okay. So I2 square common we have taken from this. So what you will get here, see, I1 by I2 is K. So K square, what does it mean? Whenever R1 you transmit from primary to secondary, you have to multiply it by K square. And same is the thing for reactance also, impedance also. So see, R1 you are transmitting to secondary. So multiply it by K square and then that will become R1 dash. So you can call it as an equivalent resistance of primary referred to secondary. And on secondary already R2 is there and this R1 dash. So that total you can represent as R2E and it is called as total equivalent resistance referred to secondary. Same is the thing for reactance also. Same thing. See, X2 is already there, X1 dash. So X1 dash is X1 into K square. Okay. This one. And similarly, X2E. X2 is X2 plus X1 dash. Any difficulty with this?
See? No, ma'am.
What the thing? So we'll see the numerical on this topic, whatever we have seen. So we'll show you. No one will ask you to draw. Only this one you just see. This is sufficient. You can have look at this also. So see here. This is what referred to primary. So whatever the values, see, referred to primary. So whatever R2 dash will be what? R2 by K square. This one is X2 by K square. This one we'll see what is it. In numericals, it will be clear to you. And means whenever we say it's a Z2 dash, So it is R2 by K square and X2 by K square. Using that, you have to calculate the Z2 dash. Okay. We'll see the number. See, yahan pe diya hai everything given to you. Okay. So no one will ask you for EMF and current. Huh? Only what I told you, R2, X2 and Z2. This one only requires. Clear? Similarly, see, referred to secondary. Ye dekho, yahan pe sab dash, dash, dash hai. So what is its value? That is also given here. R1 into K square, X1 into K square, Z1 into K square. Again, I am telling you, only you will get asked question on R, X and Z, not on voltage and current. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we'll see the numerical on this. See here. See here, 18, this one. So it's a 15 KVA. 15 KVA. KVA rating is given. Full load KVA rating, 15 KVA. Primary side voltage 2200. Secondary side 110 volt. Means it's a step down transformer. It has R1 diya. Means it's a resistance of primary winding, copper resistance. Copper resistance of secondary winding is also given. So all of you can see here, resistances of primary and secondary winding are very less, isn't it? Less voltage is there on secondary. So less turns will be there on secondary. So lesser resistance is there on secondary. Got it? Now see, leakage reactances are also given. Reactance is given. We are seeing for leakage reactance, any reactance, whether inductive, capacitive, unit is ohm. So X1 and X2. So equivalent resistance referred to primary. First one, see, equivalent resistance referred to primary means R1E you will calculate or R2 dash? Okay, right now as you have learned it may be difficult, but you got na equivalent resistance referred to primary means what? R1 plus R2 dash, and R2 dash is what? R2 by K square. See here, everyone got it? Equivalent resistance referred to primary side resistance plus R2 dash, where R2 dash is R2 by K square. Just value you have to put. How you can calculate K? Here I told you nothing is given means consider the transformer under no load condition. Under no load means this V1 and V2 you can consider as E1 and E2. So you can, using this you can calculate the value of K. So what is K? V2 by V1. Isn't it? Or E2 by E1. K is V2 by V1 is equals to E2 by E1. So it will be 0.05. K can everyone calculate?
Yes, sir.
E2 by E1, V2 by V1. So don't do reverse. Otherwise, you will lose your marks. So again, you can cross check. We have seen, if it's a step down transformer, means turns on secondary will be less, means value of K will be less than 1. So you see here K is less than 1. So here 0.05 we got K. Now all values you have, R1 and R2 you have, can you calculate equivalent resistance referred to primary? Any difficulty with first one? Only in formula you
have the value.
Similarly, second one, what you have been asked? Equivalent resistance referred to secondary. So referred to secondary formula we know. R2 plus R1 dash, and R1 dash we know. R1 into K square. R1, R2 already given. K we have find out. So just put the value and calculate. Similarly, equivalent reactance referred to primary and equivalent reactance referred to secondary. So same formula. Any difficulty for reactances and resistances?
No, ma'am.
ठीक है, easy है. Only value you have to put, just calculate the K and this formula you should write correctly and go on putting the value. Okay, I'll post forward it today to all of you. This one file. So this 4 over. Then impedance, equivalent impedance referred to primary, referred to secondary. Now see, referred to primary, you know this one. and referred to secondary also, you know. So impedance means what? On primary, now equivalent circuit, you remember what is there on primary? Resistance is there and reactance is there. So here it is marked as ye capacitor hai ya inductor hai? This one
inductor.
Inductor hai. So R and XL. Remember the formula. Z is what? R plus J X1. Isn't it? If it's a series RL, what is the formula for impedance? R plus J X. Isn't it? Okay. So same here. Now R1E you know and X1E you know. So just do it. R1E plus J X1E. Any difficulty with the formula? Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Similarly, on secondary side, R2E plus JX2E is Z2E. And magnitude you can calculate or use the calculator. Convert this rectangular to polar. You will get this magnitude and some angle also. Or here, polar not required. See, A jo numerical hai na, this one in third unit, here polar form. Not required. So what you can do, directly only calculate the magnitude. Okay. Yeah, then use rectangular to polar and or calculator, whatever you are getting, write just polar, that is magnitude only you write here. Isn't it? Because if you do this on calculator, it takes more time. So just on calculator say polar of this, you will get magnitude and angle both. Just write magnitude only. That one also you can do. Any difficulty with this sum up to this?
No, ma'am.
Then I1 full load. You, all of you can calculate now I1 full load KVA rating divided by V1. You got this one. Now see, this is important. Last one. Ye abhi aap dhyan do idhar. Total copper loss. So, any method you can use. See, I can calculate I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. Isn't it? All parameters you can calculate. I1 full load, I2 full load. फुल लोड कॉपर लॉस पूछा है ना. सो ये यहाँ पे देखो I1 फुल लोड आपने कैलकुलेट किया है. कैन यू कैलकुलेट सेम I2 फुल लोड आल्सो? यस और नो? कैन यू कैलकुलेट? I2 फुल लोड यू कैन कैलकुलेट. नाउ यू गॉट I1 फुल लोड, I2 फुल लोड कॉपर लॉस. एंड डू यू गिवन, हियर इट इज गिवन R1 R2. यस, वैल्यूज ऑफ R1 R2 आर गिवन टू यू.
यस.
So you can calculate I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2, where I1 and I2 will be full load values. So you can calculate the copper loss, full load copper loss, isn't it? If nothing is given, means you have to calculate copper loss at full load only. Okay? Okay, this is the one method. Or another method is what? Ye dekho, abhi ye jo humne derive kiya tha na formula. Another formula means you can calculate like this also. Ye dekho, this one. Ye dekho, this one referred to primary. Primary copper loss. You use this formula where I1 and I2 values will be full load. Or simplify karke ye kya aaya? Yahan pe dekho. What we got? I1 square R1E. Means what is the conclusion? To calculate the copper loss, you either use this formula or use this formula. That is the meaning. Dono formula you keep in your mind. Got the thing?
Yes, ma'am.
Or teen formula. This is the one formula. This is the second formula. And what is the third one formula? See, ye formula. Agar aap I2 square common lete ho, to ye. Out of these three, using any formula, you can calculate the copper loss. Any difficulty with this?
No, ma'am.
ठीक है, अभी देखो इन्होंने कौन सा फॉर्मूला यूज किया है. I1 फुल लोड स्क्वायर R1E. सो आइदर यू यूज दिस फॉर्मूला I1 फुल लोड स्क्वायर R1E, यू आर गेटिंग दिस वैल्यू. और यू यूज I2 फुल लोड स्क्वायर R2E, यू विल गेट द सेम आंसर. और कैलकुलेट I1 स्क्वायर R1 प्लस I2 स्क्वायर R2, देन ऑल्सो same value. Means by all three methods, all three formulas, see here, cross check given. See, isn't it? Same answer. Dekho, same answer. Okay. ठीक है. एनी डिफिकल्टी विद दिस?
नो मैम.
नो मैम.
सिर्फ इसका एडवांटेज क्या है देखो, अगर आपने ऑलरेडी आर वन ई ऊपर कैलकुलेट ही किया है इजंट इट, तो ऑलरेडी इफ यू हैव कैलकुलेटेड आर वन ई देन ओनली यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट आई वन और आई टू फुल लोड एंड यू विल गेट इट. बट इफ यू आर यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला, ये अगर आप यूज करते हो तो कंपल्सरी यहाँ पे आपको आई वन फुल लोड एंड आई टू फुल लोड बोथ यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट. तो डिफरेंस ध्यान में आया कि रेफर टू प्राइमरी या रेफर टू सेकेंडरी हम कैलकुलेशंस करते हैं तो आपको लेस कैलकुलेशंस करना है इजंट इट. और अगर आप सेपरेटली करते हो तो आई वन फुल लोड आल्सो यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट एंड आई टू फुल लोड आल्सो यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रांसफर ऑफ पैरामीटर्स. सो ट्रांसफर ऑफ पैरामीटर्स क्लियर एवरीवन?
यस मैम.
ठीक है, ये टॉपिक समझ में आ गया ट्रांसफर ऑफ पैरामीटर्स. बाकी तो ये आपको पता है, ये आप पढ़ लेना न्यूमेरिकल. वट एवर वी हैव सीन अप टिल नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दैट इट इज ओनली ओके ले लेते हैं, दो ही मिनट है. बट इफिशियंसी येट वी हैव नॉट फिनिश्ड विद इफिशियंसी, उसके पहले का पार्ट ले लेते हैं. इफिशियंसी नेक्स्ट, इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी मीन्स यू आर डिविजन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर.